Hey, you see me?
Hey, what's up, brother?
What's up, bro? How you doing?
You look like you just woke up and the room is all red. What's going on?
Yeah, I have some different. So I have these lights. I have different color lights in my room. So now, anytime I have a red day, I change the color of the light. So this has been pretty green for about 2 weeks now. So I'm just keeping these same color lights.
As long as it works, guys. So the whole concept behind all these superstition is just to get rid of anxiety.
Yeah.
Warm sway and all that. So as a trader, guys, the worst thing you can have is anything that's giving you stress, right? So whatever it takes, man, rituals, routine, whatever it takes, guys.
As ridiculous as it is, it's like you said about you made a feng shui Instagram live. So that explains a lot of stuff, too.
It's all about the power of the mind, right? If you feel confident, that's what happens, right?
Yep.
It's like wear your lucky shirt, right? If you wear your lucky shirt, something's going to happen. And it turns out you lost, so that lucky shirt is no longer lucky. So
Val was wearing his lucky pajamas for a year almost.
Dude, that was pretty crazy, yeah.
So let me talk about a couple things, guys. So like Val said, we have our meetup coming up. It's going to be August 19th to the 21st in Provo, Utah. So we're going to formally announce all the details pretty soon. But the way it's going to work, guys, is going to be a giant meetup from 11 to 3 in Utah, where, you know, we're going to set up a panel, we're going to talk, we'll bring on some members, you know, we'll highlight some stories and kind of talk about the market and, you know, what people could do to improve and make money. Because like Bao said, the market really isn't hard. People are just not focused on the right things. And then after at night, around 6 or 7 o'clock, our broker partner, Success Trader, is going to be hosting a mixer where, you know, you get to meet the broker behind the scenes. That's helps us find shares to short of these companies, guys. So during the day, you'll have access to me, Bao, and the entire MIC team. And at night, you'll have access to Success Trader and their team. So it should be a really, really fun day. And we'll probably have the schedule that we have set up, guys. It's going to be Friday night. It's going to be like a low-key networking meet and greet. Saturday is going to be the meetup during the day. Saturday night is going to be the mixer with the broker. And Sunday is when everyone's going to head out, or you can make it a vacation and stay a little bit longer, whatever you decide.
Yep. More information is going to come. You do not have to be a member to attend.
Yep. So it's free for all, everyone. It's free. No timeshares, nothing that we're going to sell you. You guys can show up and just pretty much get the chance to meet us, right? You know, we are not afraid to meet traders. We are not afraid to meet anyone because, you know, we don't scam people. So there's nothing to be fearful of, you know?
Yeah, especially these hard times, guys. It's good to make friends. I mean, this is the opportunity because, you know what, man? When the markets are heating up, it's very difficult to take time off. It's very difficult to study and learn new things and watch videos, right, guys? So we always wish, like, man, I wish that I had more free time. And then now everybody has so much free time because the markets are so slow. What the hell are you guys doing?
Yeah.
So take advantage, guys.
Yeah. So let's talk about the market, Bao. So you had a really good topic that you were talking about today about the market being tough. And, you know, we're still showing up every single day and we're making money. Bull market, bear market, doesn't matter. So you want to kind of explain, you know, what we've been doing differently than everyone else, because everyone else is losing money, bro. Everyone except us. And that's why we're getting trolled the most.
Yep. So let me talk about that right now. Hold on. Let me put this in my version. We always hear people talk about, dang, these markets are hard. I'm not making money. What's going on? Bear market this, bull and giraffe market that. But to be honest, guys, I've been trading for a long time, man. It's all the same shit. All the same shit. What is a bear market? What is a bull market? When you talk about a bear market, you talk about a macroeconomic cycle. We are day traders. Every fucking day. I don't give a fuck if it's a moose market. It doesn't matter to me because we are so short term, right? That's we're day trader. Within a day, how can you have a bear market? So those are the terms that economists and all these people give you to kind of explain it and also scare you, right? And so the only thing is this, guys. The process, whatever your process is your process, okay? Stick to the fucking process. The problem people have is this. It may take you 2 days, 3 days, a week in order for your setup to come. And that's because, you know what, the markets are slow. And so when you're talking about a bear market, you're talking about a very slow market where stocks have a very hard time of going up because there is no hype. People are scared to buy. People have no money to buy. And so you have to be realistic. You have back when the markets were hot, there were the meme stocks, you know, AMC and GameStop. They're going crazy. So the people that think that that's a normal market, what's going to happen is when things slow down, they're going to try to force it. They're like, well, we gave the analogy in the room today, like trading is like fishing, right? You go in late, and yesterday you caught four big fish. So when you go today, do you expect to make catch four fish every single day? That's what they call it, fishing. You know, they call it fishing. You're going to fish. It's not called catching, right? If it's that simple, they call it catching. There'd be days where you sit with no catches.
Yeah.
The other days you have 25 fish and you cannot fit it on the board, on the boat, right, guys?
Yeah.
But do you change your – you can. So this is the thing, guys. So same thing with trading, okay? So the bear market for a fisherman is a drought, right? There's nothing to catch. And so he can change his process. That's the whole thing. So I talked about – we talked about this in the room, guys. So for trading, it's like this, okay? You have a process, and your process is revolving around A setups, whatever you define to be an A setup. Okay, and the problem is though, waiting in a bear market. What bear market I mean is like a slower market, is that these setups do not happen often, and so you're just sitting there, and so it's like going to a desert where you have no water, and you see illusions in the, you see like lakes everywhere because you want to see that water. You're so thirsty for a trade, and so the C and B setups start to look like A plus setups because you're like, man, I've been sitting here for 2 days. There's nothing good. This is close enough. And so
you're getting desperate. The problem is getting desperate. And when you get desperate to try to offset the lack of opportunity, you oversize, right? Imagine the point of using size, guys, is it's supposed to be when there's an edge. When you know that the odds are in your favor, that is when you size. You don't size because it's slow. And what a lot of people have done in this market, whether it be, you know, we're in July now, but 7 months, what people have been doing is they've been sizing in just because it's slow and not sizing in when there's opportunity. So today for me, we had this stock MTEK. Let me show you guys. MTEK. I identified that this line over here around 170 needed to break. It broke. I shorted it. I got out. And now it's going even lower without me, right? And this is a $100 trade. I didn't get rich off this trade, but you know, in these markets, we're still finding opportunities. And just because slow on that specific trade, I'm not going to use 10 times my size. I'm not going to use 20 times my size. I'm actually using less size because the opportunity is not in my favor, guys. So if you find yourself struggling in this market, are you oversizing? If the answer is yes, size down. If you are trading stocks that you are not normally trading, like let's say, Bao, you are a bass fisher and the bass season is dried up, you're not going to go into the shark-infested waters and try to catch a shark, because that's a different type of fish. If there's no bass that day, there's no bass that day. So you should stick to that, you know? So that's what a lot of people are doing, guys. They're oversizing. They're overtrading. They're getting out of their selected niche and trying other stuff. And it's okay to experiment, but people are experimenting with too much size in this market, guys. And, you know, here we are 7 months into the year, and we're still doing pretty freaking well, you know?
So another word that we always talk about is do not deviate from your process. And that's what you guys are doing. You're deviating from process because you know what? You get the human nature, like, you know, you get bored, man. When you get bored, you start to start forcing things. And so that's the only thing. So we always talk about what makes a good day trader, guys. You don't have to be smart to be a good day trader, guys. You have to be disciplined. The best day traders are very disciplined individuals. They follow their rules and they cut their losses and they don't get FOMO. And so these markets, once again, the topic, you know, you're making trading harder than it needs to be. It's because of the fact that there's less opportunity. And so you are trading subpar setups. Okay? Imagine if you don't trade those subpar setups, making zero is still better than losing money. So you see a lot of these experts, they expect to make the same money that they made last year. That does not work like that. Same thing as a fisherman. You caught 10 fish yesterday. Today, you may catch none. But if you force yourself, like Alex says, to start catching other things, a shark may fucking jump out of the water and eat you, right? So, you know, so you have to be very careful, guys. The thing with trading is this, it's not a guaranteed occupation. You catch what you eat what you catch. It's like a caveman. If you don't have Safeway or CVS to go buy food. You got to go in and hunt the animals, right? And today you may not catch any animals. Just because you caught two big, you know, pigs yesterday, it doesn't mean today you're going to catch the same pig. Those pigs are scarce. So as a trader, guys, you have to be disciplined to be humble, to say. So I hear a lot of traders say, I'm taking a pay cut this year. Pay cut? I didn't know you had a salary job. I didn't know that. Who the hell promised you that you ain't going to make money trading? Yeah. Right? Trading's an odds, a probability game. And so if you are trading subpar setups, you are gambling. And that's all these guys are doing now. They are so frustrated because they're so arrogant because they come into the markets thinking that the markets should give them something. They feel entitled, okay? And they may have one or two good years and they think they're the expert traders. And they have not seen the cycle yet. So this cycle, I hate using the word bear market, but it's a slow cycle right now. And the market's been going up for how long now? Like 14 straight years. And so they're printing money like crazy. Now, we don't know what's going on, guys. So now they're like, oh, shit. So you cannot be complacent with the trades that you do. You have to understand the markets and change and adapt with the markets. The algos are changing. Why are you doing the same shit you used to do?
On top of changing with the market too, Bao, I think a lot of people have to understand, adapt their lifestyle as well. A lot of people, they live above their means, right? Let's say you're making $50,000 a year. They're spending $50,000 or $60,000 or even $70,000. A lot of people are going into debt, guys. So be able to adjust your life as well, right? If you went out to dinner 5 days a week when the market was hot, now you have to adjust and maybe go out to dinner once a week or not even at all, right? So a lot of people, what they don't do is they don't reduce their expenses as well. They don't live underneath their means, right? So a lot of people are struggling, right? Forget the regular market. Oil is up like crazy. Groceries are up like crazy. Everything is crazy. Travel is expensive. But a lot of people have not adjusted their lifestyle to say, you know what? The money's not coming in the same way it used to. I'm struggling a little bit right now. Maybe I'm not going to fill up my car with 93 octane. Maybe I got to fill it up with fucking 87 octane just to be able to save some money. So don't be caught in the mindset of you got to keep fucking spending your money. You got to keep wasting your money. Something that Bao taught me is you have to save your money. Save your money. And a lot of people are still wasting their money. So keep that in mind as well, guys. If you're struggling a little bit in the market or the real world or whatever it is, it's not time to keep spending and making these crazy credit card purchases and buying yourself an 85-inch TV. It's time to kind of downsize a little bit too, right? And that's why I try to live underneath my means so that when hard times like this come, whether it be in the world or whatever it is, I'm not affected because I have not been wasting my money, you know?
Well, this is all a part of learning how to run your own business. Trading is running your own business. You're an entrepreneur. Right. And so as any business, you save, right. And when things are good, you save, you stockpile the money because you know what, man, there may be slow periods. And so these are the learning experience that you go through. And if you join MIC, I mean, this is not a push for MIC by any means, but dude, if you're a new trader, you have no clue what to expect. You expect every day will be good. But then you talk to an experienced trader who's been doing this a long time. He's going to tell you, dude, save your fucking money. This shit may not last. You may have long drawdowns. You know, these are the things that you learn along the way. So you can either learn them on your own or you can have a mentor that's been through there. So you do not have to lose and learn on your own. Most people will never make it out of these cycles because they go broke before they learn. And a lot of times you don't even know what the hell you're doing because you're like, you don't even know you're doing wrong. And then later on, experience. So that same thing with life, man, like your parents have been through there. So get your parents' advice on where the hell it may be, like dating or business or school or whatever it may be, guys. So same thing. So my whole thing is this, guys. The arrogance keeps us from asking for help. Like men do not like to ask for directions. Right? I mean, fuck. How many times I'm fucking driving? My girlfriend's like, let's fucking ask directions. I'm like, nah, dude, I got it. Right? So I'm fucking driving. Next, you know, all right, man. I'm going to ask for directions. That's the only fucking shit. It's the ego of all this fucking shit. Same thing with women, right? Same thing with fucking women. Whatever you think you're good at, you ecosystem, right?
It's true, bro. It's true. That's the thing. And a lot of people, they don't know how they made money the last 2 years, right? Because they got lucky. So these people made money 2020, 2021. All of a sudden, 2022, they lost all and more, right? And they don't know why. They don't know what the hell's going on. So, guys, this is, again, you know, we are here to help. We have been here consistently for almost 4 years now, every single day coming on here and teaching. But what we teach is boring. We have no hot girls. We don't have any fancy things to show. And that's why no one really watches these videos. So the small amount of people that watch these videos are changing their lives. And that's why we do it, right? We do it to help anyone that wants to learn how to be helped. We are here to help the serious people only. And, you know, whether that be 100 people, 1,000 people, or 100,000 people, it doesn't matter because we're still going to show up. We're still going to do our part. And if you guys are here watching this, you already have an edge. You have a YouTube channel of 1,000-plus free videos of just straight stock market university education. So start using it. The markets are slow. It's a bear market. Why not use the extra time you have to watch some videos? That's it.
This is the weird thing with our industry, Alex. Our industry is the only industry where people think they could they can do it on their own, and that people that teach are stupid.
Yeah.
Even LeBron James has a coach. Everybody has a coach. Tom Brady has a coach. What makes you think that trading, you don't need a coach? That's the weirdest fucking shit. Only in trading, and it deals with money, when people go, I can fucking learn everything on my fucking own. And the weird thing is, no one's successful. Not many people become successful. So what they do is they try to learn on their own, they go broke, and they assume just because they cannot do it that it is impossible. But the reality is, what is the biggest money generator sector out there? Stocks and real estate.
Yeah.
In real estate. Goldman Sachs, all these companies are designed to make fucking money. How come they can't make money? Yeah. It's not a scam. It's just because you can do it. So the whole thing is, guys, is the ego, guys. Just like, I'll give you an example. Dude, I've been playing golf for like fucking 15, 20 years. I refuse to get a lesson. I still suck. And these little fucking 5-year-old kids are kicking my ass. You know? So that's the only fucking thing, man. It's like some of these things that... We are just too fucking stubborn, man. And so over time, we double down on our excuse as to why we don't fucking get help. And that's what it is, guys. So if you want, trading's not for everybody, guys. But my whole thing that Alex is saying, you don't need to make it hard on yourself. Get help, ask for help. Okay. If you do not ask for help, you're not humble down. This is not an industry for you, because you will go broke. You will go fucking broke.
It's your chance to come to the meetup, guys. If you guys are struggling traders, if you guys are successful traders, if you guys are business owners, whatever it may be, this is your chance to come and meet hundreds of other like-minded people that want to make money and learn how to improve their lives, right? That's the whole point. You know, when I first started trading, I would kill to have a room of hundreds of successful people helping me out for free. Free. If we wanted, we could charge thousands of dollars for this event. If we wanted, but we don't, right? We don't. So, I mean,
others do actually, right? Maybe we should.
I mean, maybe we should, bro. Maybe we fucking should.
I think we just charge like $20, man.
Maybe we should, bro. I don't know what that, like, it's after a certain point, guys, like, we've done our part, right? We've done our part and we show up. And what would happen one day if Bao and I said, you know, fuck it, we're going on an island, and you guys are fucked. So you guys might as well enjoy the education. You guys might as well, you know, take advantage of it, because shit, no one else is doing it.
Yeah, and like you said, man, there's not going to be any more sales for a while, guys. So we're done with sales for a while. We did enough, and right now the markets are sucky, man. And if you save your fucking money, I'm telling you guys right now, save your money. You rather be studying and saving your money than forcing trades. And so this is why people are losing, guys. People are losing because they have not seen these market conditions before. But it's the same shit. They're just not used to not trading. It's okay to make, like, what did you do, Alex? Like, you made one little ass trade today.
I made like $100, bro. I made nothing. But to me, I mentioned in the room that I'm not judging myself based on my profits, guys. I judge myself based on my process. Today was a process day for me. And so what? The process didn't spit out money. Some days it spits out money like an ATM. Other days it spits out $100, right? And sure, $100, still fucking a full tank of gas these days, right? So there's nothing to complain about, you know?
Yep.
So, guys, I think we're going to wrap it up here. If you guys want more information, if you guys want to come see us at the meetup, Utah, August 19th to 21st, we will release the information. If you guys want free education, we have a free webinar going at myinvestingclub.com/webinar. You do not have to be a member to attend the meetup. And I hope you guys are getting value from these videos. If you guys just are here looking to learn for free, go to the older videos of MIC. They are still relevant. They are high quality. And you guys can learn for free.
And webinar. Tell them the webinar. This is meant for people that are currently not in MIC.
Correct. Myinvestingclub.com/webinars for non-MIC members. It shows a free lesson and a live trade from me. MIC members already have access to this. And if you guys are already in the community, if you guys are already showing up every single day, Bao posted a fucking monster amount of trades today. Bao, before we go, I'm just going to show a couple of your trades that you showed. This guy, Bao's a fucking robot, this guy, bro. Look at this shit. Non-fucking-stop trading. Non-stop. This guy's pulling money out of every single
Alex, that's why I don't understand why people say he's fucking slow in hard markets. We're doing the same fucking shit, dude.
Bro, this Bao's a fucking crazy fucker, bro. Look at this. He's still, look at all this shit. These are sick-ass trades, man. Look at this.
Yeah, the M-Tech trade was pretty good.
And they're still – this is only fucking – look, it's still going, bro. So, and this is my trade, right? This is my trade. Nothing crazy, babe. $100, and we show it all in the room every single day, guys. We show everything. We guide you. We mentor you. This is what trading should be. MIC started on the concept of mentorship is the shortcut to success. And Bao, I'm very proud to say that we've stuck to our vision from day one, and we've helped thousands of people, man. So if you guys want to learn, cool. If you guys don't want to learn, cool. We're still going to be here every single day. Love you, Bao, and we'll see you guys probably tomorrow.
All right, thanks for coming on, I guess, guys. Thanks, Alex. Love you. See you back in the room.